Hi there, Doug Stuman with IT Creations with a tower server from Gigabyte. This one is the W291-Z00. So far, there are only two revisions from the base model, Rev 100, which only supported first generation AMD EPYC 7001 series processors. Then it got the upgrade at Rev B00 to support first and second generation AMD EPYCs. The last revision for this system is the Rev C00, adding support for third generation AMD EPYC 7003 series processors. This system is designed for AI, visual computing, and general networking applications. Let's take a look. I mean, this Rev C00 has to be the last revision because the recently released AMD EPYC 9004 series processors have a completely different socket and it won't even fit. That said, nice that AMD went three generations of CPUs with the same socket. Can you use it for a workstation? Yes and no. Yes, as a network attached workstation because it runs server software, and no, not as a personal workstation because Windows and other Linux operating systems are not mentioned in the specifications or the supported OS matrix. Although if you have to have that all-powerful workstation under or on top of your desk, the Gigabyte W771-Z00 will do the trick. It has similar specs to this system, aside from the AMD Threadripper CPU, but some lucky person gets it all to themselves. Video here. For this one, today we're looking up at 2 terabytes of memory, a single EPYC CPU, and multi-GPU support with a bunch of drive bays. The front bezel is lockable, but once we pass that barrier, you can see a media bay at the top. Next, 4 drive bays below that, and what looks like potentially more room for drive cages, but is really for airflow. To the left of those, a small control panel, which actually makes more sense when the chassis is placed on its side. That first one is an ID button in case you rack mount this system, a power on button, non-maskable interrupt, and reset buttons. Then 2 USB 3.0 ports. Just below those, LEDs for LAN 1 and LAN 2, and a system status LED. Are you interested in the Gigabyte W291-Z00 server tower? For a limited time, you can save up to $500 off a system listed on our site, or one that you can configure yourself that's valued at $5,000 or more. Just click that link to find more information on this system and how you can be saving and living a better life with a Gigabyte tower server. Mention this video to reap the rewards when you're ready to buy. On the back panel, dual redundant PSUs at the top of the chassis, then the system ID button, on-off button, 2 1 gigabit Ethernet LAN ports, 2 USB 3.0 ports, and a server management port with VGA port below that. Then you have the PCI card bays with 9 slot covers. The dedicated management port provides access to the ASSPEED AST2500 baseboard management controller inside the chassis for managing the system remotely or at chassis. Like Gigabyte's other server platforms, this system can also be managed using the pre-installed Gigabyte management console. The management console allows for real-time health monitoring and management through a standard browser interface. It's also compatible with IPMI specifications, features event recording, and can help you manage SAS, SATA, or NVMe storage devices, and remotely control Broadcom MegaRAID adapters like that cordyceps fungus in The Last of Us. Have you seen that? It's pretty good so far, but I do hope they don't drag it out, you know, like The Walking Dead. The other option which leverages the Gigabyte management console is the Gigabyte Server Management, or GSM. Basically more robust features made for multiple servers and offers a few more tools for multiple server management. One thing I forgot to mention, both are free of charge. Once we open the case, you can see the general layout with storage to the front, fans, then the motherboard with CPU and memory modules above the PCI slots down below. As I said earlier, that CPU socket is compatible with 3 generations of AMD EPYC processors, just not the latest 9004 series processors. With a configurable thermal design power rating of up to 240 watts, this system can take CPUs with 8 to 64 physical cores and 16 to 128 virtual threads, useful for virtualized environments. L3 cache supported by these CPUs ranges from 32 megabytes up to 256 megabytes. To either side, 4 DDR4 DIMM slots that can be outfitted with registered, load reduced, or 3DS versions of those memory modules, which will support up to 2 terabytes. The standard RDIMMs or LRDIMMs will provide about half that memory capacity at up to 1 terabyte. There are 4 slim SAS connectors on the motherboard. The upfront drive bays can be populated with SATA or SAS drive types, but for SAS implementations, you will need a SAS PCIe card for SAS drive support. The 4 3.5-inch bays can support 3.5-inch or 2.5-inch drive types. 3.5-inch drives don't require any tools, while the 2.5-inch drives have 4 screws to lock them into position. A single x4 PCIe Gen 3 connector on the system board can be used for an NVMe or SATA M.2 drive that can be used to support the OS. Also great for super fast startup. If more storage is required, there are a few PCIe NVMe SSDs listed that can provide up to 4 terabytes of storage each. Not going to lie to you, those are still somewhat expensive. While this platform does support AMD EPYC 7003 series CPUs that do support up to 128 PCIe 4.0 lanes, this system only supports PCIe 3.0 in the PCIe slots. There are 5 PCIe 4.0 slots, all with a x16 physical length and a x16 PCIe link, except for one. That last one has a x8 length and a x8 PCIe link. The x8 slot is right in the middle and squeezed between 2x16 slots. The system can be outfitted with up to 4 double-wide GPUs. That air duct directs fresh air over the GPUs and out the back of the system. More current GPUs are most likely supported as long as the wattage is no more than the 250 watts. The A100 features Ampere architecture and still supports that 250 watt threshold, but also supports a PCIe Gen 4 throughput, so you may not get all of the performance out of that card, but you will get more performance than the V100. Supporting the up to 1000 watt power draw with 4 GPUs installed would be dual redundant 1600 watt 80 plus platinum level PSUs. For distributed environments, you may even want to install a few NVIDIA T4 GPUs, then you would actually get to use that x8 PCIe slot right in the middle. Perhaps add a SAS card or a high-speed NIC card. Who knows? Featuring a high core count CPU, room for up to 4 GPUs, and 2 terabytes of memory, this system is a flexible appliance. It can be configured to support a number of workloads, including visual computing, AI, and your basic networking functions like file storage, a shared VPN connection, or use as a virtual server for AI applications. We're talking about deep learning and scientific analysis and simulation. If you're looking for this tower server or some other server, professional workstation, or looking for an upgrade to one of your existing systems, try IT Creations. Simply go to itcreations.com and click one of those links on the side right there. Until next time, I'm Doug Stuman with IT Creations, and thanks for watching.